In this tutorial, I'll show you how to easily add a watermark to your photos with a single click of a brush tool. But before I can create this custom brush, I first need to produce a watermark. To do this, I'll start by creating a new empty image with the new option in the Affinity Photo file menu. This is to give me a working image where I can create my watermark. The important thing is that it needs to be of a reasonable size so that you can see what you're doing. I'll be using my YouTube thumbnail preset for this, which produces an image that's 1920 by 1080 pixels. My next step is to fill the image with black using the flood fill tool. That's going to make it easier to see the white text of my watermark when I work with it. To add the text of the watermark, I'll use the artistic text tool. If we look at the context sensitive toolbar, you can see the different text options. I want to use white text for the watermark, which I'll pick by clicking the color swatch. I also want to use a large font size to help me see the text, so I'll pick 144 point. Don't worry about getting the font size right at this stage though, because we're going to change it in a minute. We just need to be able to see the individual letters we're working with clearly. The main text I want to use for the watermark is my name, so I'll enter that first. Now using the Move tool, I can select the text to move it around the image. But I can also use this to resize the text by clicking and dragging these side and corner handles. The next step is to choose a more inspiring font for the watermark. The best font to use for a name is a script style font to make it look like a signature. I'll use one called Whisper, which I've already downloaded from the Google Fonts website. I'll include the link to it in the YouTube video description. Having changed the font, I need to resize the text again because it's looking a little small to work with. The effect I want to create is having the first letter in both of my names appear larger than the rest of the text. If I double click on the text of my name, Affinity Photo switches me back to using the artistic text tool. Now I can select the text that I want to resize in my first name. What I'm trying to do when I resize the font is set a relationship between the size of the first letter and the rest of the text. Now I can repeat the step with my other name. This is probably going to leave your watermark looking a little small, so select the Move tool again. Then use one of the corner drag handles to resize it. Using the corner handle keeps the width and height of the text in proportion. In the next step of creating this watermark, we're going to work with the individual letters in the text. But before we can do that, we should duplicate the layer in case we make any mistakes. If we need to start over again, it means we don't need to repeat everything we've done so far. I'll just turn off the visibility on the original layer so that it's not distracting when we edit the watermark. Now be sure to select the new layer in the Layer Studio panel and have the text selected with the Move tool. You'll then see the Convert to Curves button in the toolbar. Click this and it converts the watermark text into a group of layers, each layer containing a different letter of the text. Now I can reposition the individual letters in the watermark. All I need to do is click the layer with the letter and then drag it into position. I can also use the arrow keys on my keyboard to nudge them into position. This allows me to make the letters of the watermark overlap just like they would in a signature. In a minute, I'm going to add my website address to the watermark. But before I do that, I'm going to make the R in my first name larger and also move it down in the text. I'll then select all the layers for the letters that make up my first name and I'll rotate them slightly. This gives my first name in the signature a nice angle. I can then continue to select, move, size, rotate, and even stretch the different parts of the watermark to produce something that looks unique. Having done that, I can add my website address using the artistic text tool again. As before, I need to choose a suitable font. This time I'll pick a regular style font rather than a script so that it gives a more professional feel. A couple of rules of thumb to help you are, don't use more than two fonts for your watermark, and if you have two elements of text, don't use a script font for both of them. I'm going to pick a serif based font for this, which is copperplate, and I'm going to use a lightweight. This also converts my text to use small caps, but you can use small caps with any font. All you need to do is open the Character Studio panel from the View menu. Then in the Typography section, apply the small caps option. When you have the different elements of your watermark in position, you can use them to create a custom Affinity photo brush. To create the brush, you need to use the Brushes Studio panel. If it's not visible, you can select it in the main view menu under the Studio section. When you have a lot of brushes in Affinity Photo as I do, it's a good idea to organize them into categories. I already have a category called Watermarks, but if you need to create one, select the Create New Category option in the panel menu. My next step is to merge the various layers of my watermark together onto a single layer. First though, I'll hide the black background layer so that it doesn't get added to the watermark. This means the text of my watermark is going to be on a transparent background. Then, using the Move tool, I'll select the layers that I want to merge by clicking them whilst holding down my Shift key. I'll then use the keyboard shortcut of Shift, Option, Command and E, which on a Windows PC is Shift, Control, Alt and E. This produces a new layer containing all the elements of my watermark. I can then save this as a new custom brush using the panel menu in the Brushes Studio panel. It's also a good idea to rename the brush by right-clicking the entry in the Brushes panel. Having created a watermark brush, let's look at how to apply it to a photo. All I need to do is select my brush tool in Affinity Photo and then click on the image where I want to add the watermark. And because I'm using a brush, I can change its size in either the toolbar or using the square brackets on my keyboard. The drawback with this approach though is that it applies the watermark directly to the pixels of the image. I find it's much better to first add a new empty layer using the Layers menu. You can then apply the watermark to that layer, allowing you to hide and display it. Then, if you use the Move tool, you can reposition the watermark as well as resize it. The reason that I now like to use a watermark on my images isn't to stop people copying them. Rather, it's to let people know that I took the photo and where they can find my website. You will never prevent people removing a watermark if they really want to. With a bit of careful planning, it's easy to remove anything from a photo, as I show in this video. It's a great one to watch next, and it shows the power of Affinity Photo tools. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.